Hi to all, welcome to HEF channel. You are watching health, environment, food safety, fire safety, sustainability solutions. Today we are discussing about that. What is the exactly wellness music and what is the music helps to your health and well-being? The when we will be celebrate the World Music Day. So why link up with that this music with your human relationships? So what is a wellness music? How, what is a wellness music therapy? How it is important for that? Let us will discuss about that World Music Day. The World Music Day initially celebrated the 21st June every year. Fête de la musique. The Fête de la musique is also known in English as a music day. Make Music Day or World Music Day is annual music celebration that takes place on 21st June. On Music Day, the citizens of city or country are allowed or argued to play music outside and neighbors in public places or parks. So, across cultures, study participants mostly agreed on general emotions characterize the musical sounds such as anger, joy, annoyance. But their options varied the level of arousal, which refers to the study of degree in the commonest stimulus evoked in a piece of music. So this music is emotionally powerful. It's clear the pleasure emotions lights up the mesolimbic pathway to reward bit of brain that gives a happy feelings. But that was not all. All music also create the response from that which modulate the emotions networks. It hippocamps, which centers emotions around the attachments. So let us discuss about that. What is the wellness music? Why it is a wellness music is important. The wellness music from the music industry, the pivoting the wellness music to new technology that capture our biometric data to create a personalized healing soundscapes. The music is undergoing a sudden wellness transformations. We all self-medicate through music. We have all got our I am stressed or I need energy playlist, but most people don't fully grasp just how much they depend on music to manage their emotions or just how powerful the medical evidence for music therapy. And that not only the our human heart wide for music, but they are also agree that no other stimulus positively activates so many regions of human brain with unique powers to boost mood and memory. But when you think of formal music therapy, it conjures of dowdy, dusty Greek offices in some schools or medical outstanding outbuildings with patients wearing the Soviet headphones. Suddenly something begins happening. Music as an intentional therapy is being radical reinvented. Music is emerging as one of the hottest trends in wellness, and wellness concepts are shaking up the massive music industry. Wellness music is being born, and the trend takes so many forms. Funding for medical studies on music's impacts on the brain is really heating up, with researchers using the biofeedback all and artificial intelligence and machine learning to identify how music structural properties such as a beat, key, chord progressions and timbre specifically impact biometrics like heart rate, brain waves and sleep patterns, so they can develop music and precision medicines for everything pain and PTSD. The mainstream music industry is going through wellness transformation from an explosion of healing playlist on big streaming sites such as a Spotify to new artists and audience from ambient and new age music to musicians, incorporating all kinds of wellness experience into their concerts. The newest, biggest meditation apps and are fast morphing into wellness music apps with goals such as a calm event planning and to become a whole new kind of label for artists launch music for well-being. One of the most provocative developments, the rise of generative all-powered music apps and technology platforms that pull your biological, psychological and situational data to create a utterly unique custom made for you, always changing soundscape to improve your mental and physical health anytime you want to tune in. And while the mega trend of ancient sound therapies from going bath to Tibetan singing bowls will only rise at wellness studios and the travel destinations, we'll all see more experimentation with music and acoustic experience at both mainstream and wellness travel destinations. How about a deep listening excursions in the deepest rainforest with an acoustic ecologist? So given music powerful impact on our brains and bodies, it's extraordinary little innovations there has been around intentionally designing music and sound experience that could actively, positively change our mood, health and performance. Changes here, music created a intentional medicine for being big trend in 2020 and beyond. It's not about giving up your beatless Beyonce fixes solely to biofeedback based soundscapes. It's about seeing music health and wellness potential and you with far more wellness music options, new technologies, new experience, new experiments. So it's a fueling the trend, evidence that music is a strong medicine with more studies unraveling and its unique brain mechanisms ahead. Stringent meta reviews show music's eye-opening impact on depression, anxiety and pain, and everything from its power to improve social skills in kids with autism to being a stronghold against Alzheimer's, as memories of music don't get lost to that disease. A key recent focus has been more hospitals around the world using music therapy before surgery, as new studies like one from the University of Pennsylvania revealed that music is a powerful sedative in reducing patients' anxiety. More researchers now untangling to braining mechanisms involved in listening to music and investigating the right dosages. The British Academy of Sound Therapy just found that 78 minutes daily is optimal for improving mental health. And there is a more research into the evidence-based acoustic sound design with frequencies in decibels, beats, tones have most powerful impact or what outcomes. The potential of music therapy is so immense and untapped that the National Institute of Health has just awarded the millions to the fund a sound health initiative that will undertake studies to uncover music's mechanisms of actions in the brain, as well as to identify a host of new interventions from treating symptoms of pain, Parkinson's disease, stroke, autism, and dementia to music's impact on childhood development. So this is a huge step of seriously science to understand music's serious potential for improving human well-being. So culture also change. Exhausted by screens, we are taking the sanctuary in sounds. And the stream your well-being, the music industry provides a wellness. The explosion healing wellness playing on the big stream strides new big audience ambience, new age music artists incorporating all kinds of wellness concerts. So wellness is becoming a new mode of listening. And Spotify, Apple Music, YouTube and streaming sites are increasingly all places focus on mood changing, stress reducing, help people sleep, focus enhancing, meditative, improve your workout music and soundscapes, making wellness music is a core homepage channel. There are a new endless loop stainless and tangling music channels specifying well-being intentions, and they boast millions Spotifying a chill playlist such as a deep focus, peaceful ambient life for this music. So a new era of the personalized music is the medicine. The new technology and apps radically reimagining how music can become a deep personalized precision medicine. So your biological, psychological data generates an adaptive wellness soundscapes to improve your well-being every day. So generative music is a music that largely mixes that composers and a song from the process to create compositions that endlessly evolve according to pre-programmed set of rules. A concept pioneered by 50s brain Inos in the 60 by 70 old music comp, it's taking a new meaning and applications in your digital age. So it's a wellness music is the good meditations app, and lot of apps also came for this wellness, more all wellness, the all music centers. So everything is a new sound experience will hit travel. We will see more experimentations with music and acoustic experience, both mainstream and wellness travel destinations. So all this, it increases also about music and listening experience. It's mentally, physically, you have to very strong and in this music. So in future, thus all wellness approaches, we can wonder just our desperate belief that's a magic ingredient with music. We personally experience that evidence deep impact it has mood. Music impact seems mysterious. It seems to go straight to our soul. And a recent survey, 40% of people report that music makes them cry unexpectedly. But given music's incredibly potential as health interventions and wellness, emotionally, physically, mentally, it's a very good boost for that life. And especially way to shift our emotions. And extraordinary how little innovations has been around intentionally designing music and sound experience that could actively and positively change our brains, bodies, performances. Changes here. Music is created. Your intentional medicines will be a big trend in beyond. So the people is understand that it's in 2020 instantly the fast wireless speeds and networks. And everything should be environmentally the peaceful, that the people into multi-dimensional multimedia environments will lead to even screen addictions and exhalations. More will flee into sound and music, and they will have so many more healing experience in feel of that wellness music. So wellness music is the future trends in the 2020. It is the wellness music to new technology that capture the our biometric data to create the personalized healing soundscape, and music is undergoing a sudden wellness transformations. So in this music, emotionally and physically, mentally, it's very, very important. The how music is a lot of psychiatrist, and music helps to your stress. And music helps to be the symbol of that your emotional control. So music is the good health, well-being, and it's a control of that, you know, your good sleep. Is it good sleep for that your music? So it is every activity you should be start with music, and it's a direct effect of the parasympathetic nervous systems. Which helps your body relax. It's a prepare for sleep. So all this, it is a startup for this your day activity for that music. So that is a reason the World Music Day every year 21st June celebrated, and it is a part of that your daily activity and wellness of your health, and it will be mostly important in your life. The music is in your life. You have to adapt in your music with good pleasure, without stress and anxiety. So let us awake about World Music Day on 21st June and be happy, be healthy. Thank you. Thanks a lot.